Good afternoon, guys. Let me start my lecture. I should mention about the first midterm examination. Our first midterm exam set at September the 3rd. That's going to be Saturday, and between O3:00 PM till 05:00 PM. The room will be announced later. And on this examination, as everybody know, we are going to work on what's so called the slope deflection. And there are two problems. One about the beam, and another one about the frame with side sway, because the frame without side sway is going to be very close to the beam. And we have the link over here. If you guys interested in, may visit and watch the video clip from last year. It's really short, like a 10 minutes video clips. Okay, and now we come to what we have, frame with side sway. Typically, the structure subjected to the lateral load. And again, that lateral load is going to be this, the wind load. What happened? It cannot move. Okay, the lateral load. And then, for example, this one is a simulation of the lateral load. And then lateral load is a horizontal load, right? Yes, it's a kind of horizontal load that move the frame in the horizontal direction. Let me talking about something about the deformation. When we have rotational, which is equivalent to the slope. And this one is the linear, this displacement. And we equivalent it to the linear deflection, We going to use these two definitions differently. When we talking about the rotation, and then we talking about the equilibrium, equilibrium related to the rotation is going to be equilibrium of moment. Okay, so if you go back to the beam, we use the equilibrium of the moment at the support to solve for the degree of freedom. Now we have the lateral force causing the lateral displacement. Now we are going to use this one to consider to prevent the linear deflection, or we are going to consider equilibrium of forces in the equation that's used to solve for the degree of freedom. I will mention about this later, but this one, the picture tells us that is the side sway. So we put additional equilibrium of force in this kind of problem. Now, let me go to what kind of frame that's going to have side sway. There are three of them. First, but I should mention, most of the frame, is the frame with side sway. For example, the commercial building in Thailand, even though this building, there is no support to prevent the structure from the side sway. Okay, that's why when the wind blow the structure, has some very small vibration and in static, we just consider it in the form of size wave. And then for the frame, when it's symmetric or not symmetric, when the wind blow, the rigid frame just have the size wave like this. For the some special case, let's see this one is the symmetric frame. The symmetric frame, when subjected to non-symmetric load, also have the size wave. Why? Because under this force P, the moment occur on the left is going to be larger than the moment on the right. For example, over here, let me have the frame. We put the force 40 kilonewton of the symmetric axis. You can see the size wave in this point, 0.847 millimeter. The size wave on this point is only 0.818. So this one is larger than this one. And if you run the program computer, you will see the moment at this point is larger than the moment at this point. That's why the structure has unequal rotation and cause the structure move to one direction. Okay, so don't worry. Most of the time when the frame won't have the less strain, if it didn't have the support like this, the frame will be size wave frame. Okay, anyway, the last one, we may consider the frame. This frame is non-symmetric, okay? Even though the load is symmetric, this frame, this one will be stiffer because it has two eyes. This one will be flexible. So the deformation on this one will be more than on this one. So the beam have the size wave. Okay, there is three types of them. That's for your engineering examination, not in my examination. And then coming to the example, let me move to example. On the frame with size wave, again, you must specify a proper degree of freedom. And then when we get a proper degree of freedom, you consider the slope deflection equation properly. That is two sets again, 2EI over L and TI over L. And then I don't want to think about it. I like to use only 2EI over L because it can solve any problem. And you can see if you do that, one problem, you get 5 degrees of freedom and thinking about the work that you're going to do. You don't have all day long examination. So you got to use your engineering judgment, one of very important skill. Another one is going to be engineering sense. Okay. Both judgment and sense come from practice. It's different kind of knowledge and understanding. You got to start with the knowledge. Slope deflection equation. When we talking about slope deflection equation, it's knowledge. You can remember it, right? And then you understand it because the equation has variable. And then you go to the shape of the frame. Now you start to use your skill. You got to think about the degree of freedom. You start to use your judgment, which set of equation you're going to use. This is a kind of very simple practice. When you go up, you are a big engineer. You work like a project engineer. The decision making going to be more complex than this. This one, the simplest one. And then when you get the proper slope deflection, you must find the fixed end moment. Since there is two sets of the fixed end moment, one is going to be like this. Another one is going to be like this. That's for 3EI over L. This for 2EI over L. And then you plug it back to the slope deflection equation. Now you will get series of equation. It can be 4, 5, or 6 equation. This equation contain what are looking for is going to be unknown degree of freedom. How we are going to solve for this unknown degree of freedom? You will use equation of equilibrium. And now the equation of equilibrium of the moment, this one going to less corresponding to the slope for the beam, right? Not enough. For this frame, you're going to use this equilibrium of the shear at the support. This going to be related to the size sway. This is one important difference from slope deflection for the beam, is the equilibrium equation of the shear force at the support of the frame. Okay, this one is important. Just this one is different from the beam. And then you solve for the slope deflection that you are looking for over here. And when you get it, just plug it back to the slope deflection that you have in the step number 3. Then you get the end moment. When you get the end moment, you go back to my lecture number 2. We use end moment to find the end shear. We use the end shear to draw the shear diagram, and then moment diagram, and then elastic curve, and then the reinforcement of the structure, those kind of thing. Now, let us move to this one. Okay. Again, all the moment and the slope with clockwise direction is positive. Also, the ratio of size sway divided by the length, we call this one phi, clockwise is positive. Whenever you get the negative, the direction just reverse. Okay. And now the frame has constant. This one is EI. This one has the stiffness EI. When it's subjected to the 40 kilonewton, everybody know this frame supposed to move sideways to this direction. But for the purpose of demonstration, I put it in the opposite direction to get the negative EI delta later. Okay, just show you guys. And when you have this, this one is fixed, this one is fixed. The elastic curve will provide the slope occur over here and provide the slope occur over here and the size sway. So we have total of 3 degrees of freedom. Slope at B, slope at D, and the side sway. How many degrees of indeterminacy do we have? We have fixed. We have 6 unknown at the support. We have 3 times 1 free body diagram. So this one also has 3 degrees of indeterminacy. If you like to solve this one for force method, it's going to be the same when you solve it by the displacement method. Okay, the 2 methods just provide 3 unknown, so they are equal. By doing this, you got to start. There is fixed as our discussion. So this one is 2EI over L, all of 3 members. So the problem must be kind of pretty easy. And then since you use 2EI over L, the fixed end moment that occur for the beam CD is going to be one over here and one over here. That is going to be fixed in moment. And if for the recoil, this is P, this is A, this is B. Okay, if you fix both of them, you get this one to be fixed end moment CD, and this one is going to be fixed end moment DC, and this one is going to be PAB square divided by L square. This one is going to be PBA square divided by L square. You may see they are different, and this one is going to be 40 times 3 and then 4 square divided by 7 square. But this one is going to be 40 times 4 and 3 square. This is 3 square. This is 4 square divided by 7 square. So fixed end moment CD is going to be larger than fixed end moment DC. And then you just follow this one. You get what you have, the CD. CD, again, if you consider CD, you may see the direction of CD is in the counterclockwise direction. So this one is negative. Beware about it. Most of you guys know, because I provide the equation I provide, but you incorrect only on the sign convention, or the problem you go wrong. Okay, so what I'm always say to my student, this subject is not difficult because the step very clear, but the detail of computation must be very prudent, very careful on it, especially the sign convention. And then what we have is a proper psi convention for the fixed end moment. And we move to the slope deflection equation. We have two sets of them. And then if you start, this one must be the size way. And what happened is the size way will be considered on this portion of the equation. Now, by doing this, you may see if you draw a straight line from this point to this point, you can see this is a rotation counterclockwise rotation. We call this phi sub A C. And this one is going to be delta over the length of 5. And if you consider this point, the rotation still counterclockwise. Please remember, on a column, the value of the delta over L, they always the same. And this one we call phi sub CA, and it's going to be delta over 5. And again, if you move to another column, you get the same thing. This one rotate in the counterclockwise. This is phi sub BD. That is going to be delta divided by 5. And the last one over here, this is phi sub DB. It's also delta over 5. And you can see all of them have the same negative counterclockwise rotation is minus delta over 5. And then this is going to be part of this equation. Now, from the last step, we got this one, we got this one. And for this step, we got the delta over L ratio. Then just plug all of what we have into this equation m sub ac 2ei over 5, and then this fix, when this one is fixed, the slope over here is zero. You have only this one, and then minus 3 minus delta over L, no fixed end moment, just do your part of work. See, start to be mathematics problem. So the strategy you got to have in the examination room, you got two problem, like, let's say the examination going to have like a 20 points. And believe me, the beam may have 8 or 9 points. The frame may have like 11 or 12, because the frame require more work. Okay, Ajahn, what should I select in my opinion? Select the frame. Okay, if you get full score, and most of the time, if you can do the frame, you can do the beam. Okay, that's going to give you like a C or C plus. Anyway, it's up to your strategy, not mine. And then M sub CA over here, all of the rotation that we put it into the equation, we just get the clockwise as the positive. Now, all of the end moment of the column, we move next to the end moment of the beam, and then this part of thing, work is your work. Keep doing it slowly. And I don't know, sometimes it's not the slope deflection equation, not the sign convention, how to put input calculation in your calculator, also the big problem. So try to do it slowly. Now you get 3 degree of freedom. One, theta sub C, another one, theta sub D. You may consider this equilibrium of point C. If you come to the point C over here, you use the third law of Newton. M sub CA is here. M sub CD is here. So summation of the moment about C, when you specify counterclockwise is positive, you just put it over here. And then M sub CA, you may see over here. And sorry, not this one, CA and CD. Oops. CA and CD must be over here. You just combine them together and it's gonna be zero. Okay, you get this first equation. And then for slope theta sub D, it requires you to consider summation of the moment at point D equal to zero. Now, counterclockwise is positive. Again, this one plus this one is zero. M sub DC plus M sub DB. I just rearrange it. One technique, very important technique. You got to put the variable in order. That's very important. Okay, don't just mess up. If you rearrange theta C, theta D, delta, the next one do the same thing. Now, the difference from the beam is here. Like we know, due to the size sway, we got to consider the shear force and the support. And you can see, by doing this, you just do the summation of x sub x equal to zero. Ajahn, how do you know v sub a in this direction, v sub b in this direction? Don't worry, you can put it any way you like. and the sign, the positive or negative sign will tell you at the end of calculation which one going to be the correct one. By doing this, let me put this direction is positive. So V sub A plus V sub B is zero. Now, there is no shear force in the slope deflection equation. You got to cut the column. We take the column to our consideration. We take the moment at point C. By doing this, the end moment will come to our consideration, summation of the moment at point C equal to zero. And you can see the V sub A will time this one, and then it's going to be V sub A time 5 rotate in this direction, and the moment all of them plus M sub AC plus M sub CA equal to zero. All of them rotate in the same counterclockwise direction. And then when you rearrange it, it can be V sub A equal to the end moment AC plus CA divided by 5 with the negative sign over here. That means actually it's supposed to be in the opposite direction. And then take the moment over here. You do the same thing. Okay, you get V sub B equal to this one. Now you plug V sub A over here. You plug V sub B over here. You will get the equilibrium of the shear force at the support in the form like this. Four of the end moment involved in this calculation. And then you just put everything together and you get this one as the third equation. Now you get this result. You got to compute it slowly. Okay, and then when you get it, some will be positive. That means theta sub C is going to be in the clockwise direction. And this one will be 26.946 and counterclockwise direction. You guys can write two methods. One is the negative and the number. When you put it in the positive, please provide the rotation, okay? And then this one, you get this one to be 11.583, and then it's going to be in this direction. And if Ajahn said, okay, let us have EI equal to 10,000 E, kilonewton per square meter, I is meter cube. Let the fractional stiffness, this is called fractional stiffness, to be 10,000 kilonewton meter square. What you get is theta sub C is going to be 36.212 divided by 10,000. So this one is going to be 36.212 10 minus 4. The unit is going to be radian, okay? Or you may rearrange it to be 3.6212 10 minus 3 radian, and then it's rotated in clockwise direction. Okay, if you like to compute the value, compute it. And also theta sub D. Theta sub D is going to be 2.6946 10 minus 3 radian. It's going to be in the counterclockwise direction. Okay, and how about delta? Delta is going to be 11.583 divided by 10,000. So it's going to be 11.580 × 10⁻⁴ meter. Okay. And then this one is going to be 1.1588 × 10⁻³ meter, or it's maybe 1.1583 millimeter. That's the numerical computation I like to you guys to take a note on this one. This is maybe very small, 1.1583, but it's okay. If you have time, you don't want to be very bored in my class, you may pick up your calculator and then go to the simultaneous equation and then plug every variable into your calculator. And let's see, you get the result or not. Okay, and then for this one, please take a note, it's EI theta sub C. That's why I pick you back to the numerical calculation. Okay. Please do it a lot. You're going to use it again in the, actually in the matrix. That's going to be a lot more complicated, because at the time when we go to the matrix, you got to use the matrix calculation to get the result. Anyway, when you finish this, you just plug it back to your slope division equation to get the result. This slide just show you guys about what's supposed to be. So for sure, it's not on our graph. It's going to be in the opposite direction. And then at the end of this, plug everything. One more important at this point, you just plug all you have into one each equation. To this point, you got to check two important things. The moment at this point, M sub CA and M sub CD, CA and CD, they must be equal. Okay. If not, do the average. Okay. And then over here, M sub DC over here and DB, two of them must be equal. If not, just go back to the first step and trying to track what's wrong in your computation. There must be something wrong if the result is not in equilibrium. Okay, this one and this one. This point is the most important to get a correct result. And then from this one, you go back to lecture number two, draw the free body diagram, and then compute for the end shear. And then you may start compute for the shear diagram, moment diagram, elastic curve, those kind of things. Now, let me stop on this one. I have another problem close to this one. You may go to the PowerPoint review if we have time, but I don't think we have time, because in the morning, I go to this one first. The other problem, I cannot finish it. I like to reverse it. At least the Thai student may come to video clip of this one and we will study. What the point is, I'm teach you like this, okay? And then I decide the problem in what I'm going to show you. Okay, let's switch to what we have for our example. From the first problem that we have, this one is the problem we have 2 years ago. Let us consider what the difference between this problem and the previous problem. First, the column in this problem not equal. Okay, this is a big change. I don't think so. You still use 2EI over L, 2EI over L, and 2EI over L. Okay, and then another change. I put one more load over here, 10 kilonewton. This one will provide you a clear picture. The frame will move to the right. Okay, you don't need to make approximation or guess what happened. It's going to be very clear. That helps students. And then there is the video clip. Okay, you may go through it from the previous year. And also, not previous year, previous 2 years. Previous year, I have this one. This problem is the easy one. Previous year, we have pin and we have roller. Again, this is statically determined. This problem should not be solved by the slope deflection. It can solve by slope deflection, okay? This method is very special, different from the consistent deformation. This one can use for this problem. Also, you may go to the video clip and study it by yourself. Now, let me move to another problem that I like to show you. This also another problem from, I don't know which year, but what we have is, I teach you guys from the PowerPoint and I make this one as the examination. You may see the difference. Some more different in the detail, make the result different. So keep stick with your principle and sign convention, okay? Anyway, after some Thai student asking me about the fixed end moment, okay? I put some more on this problem and let us modify this problem a little bit. Let's see, as a student, okay, we like to put the horizontal force additional compared to the problem in the slide. Okay, from the problem in the slide, I modify first like this with the 100 kilo. Actually, many years ago, it's 10 kilonewton. Okay, and like three years ago, I changed 10 to 100. Okay, and let us move to a little bit more compact. Just put this 10 kilonewton per meter into this one. Now, what happened is the frame going to be the frame with side sway. And then messes up on this, A is fixed, D is fixed. This point has a hinge joint at B. Now, the hinge move to this side. And what happened is, when you push the structure in this direction, for sure, this is fixed, this is fixed. Let's say, if we put this one, in the PowerPoint, it's hard to show. Let's say, this one has the 1.5, 15 millimeter side sway, okay? When this one have 15 millimeter side sway, this one also has 15 millimeter side sway. And we call this one as the delta. And due to the assumption, the delta at C is going to be the delta at
B. Okay, they are equal. That is going to be our first degree of freedom. Now, again, as we may know, this one is fixed. Okay, this one is fixed. And at the end of this, it's going to be, let me move this one a little bit. And since this one is a beam, it's not really fixed, but it's close to the fixed. This one will have the shape something like this. Okay. However, this one is internal hinge. It's going to be something like this. But this one going to be something like this. Okay, they are going to be different by the joint. This one rigid joint. This one is going to be internal hinge joint. And then I will get the shape. I can draw the shape of this to be, let me zoom in a little bit. Oops. This one will have the shape something going to be like this one. But this one will have the shape, this one going to be the shape, and this one. You guys, they are different. And if you want to understand kit, you may demonstrate kit by using your ruler. And then what happened is this one must keep kit in the normal angle. Okay, because it's rigid joint. And then by doing this, what happened is this portion must be linked to this one and it will have the deformation in the form like this. Now, what we have is the rotation that occur on this one compared to what original it is. You may see the rotation over here is going to be counterclockwise. And let me put this one to be theta sub c. This is going to be the second degree of freedom. Now we compare to this one. On this one as the internal hinge. The internal hinge is like the hinge on your door. It can rotate in any direction. So the rotation here is going to be theta sub b, and let's say it's going to be beam. And this one is going to be theta sub b and put it for the column. So the total degree of freedom of this problem is going to be theta sub b for the beam, theta sub b for the column, theta over here, theta sub c, and then delta. If you guys like to compute for all of this, you guys must use the general equation for this one. You got to use 2EI over L, 2EI over L, and 2EI over L to determine all the degree of freedom. This is possible in my examination design. Okay, not that too much, for is possible. And if I just said, okay, I like to have only theta sub c, delta, and theta sub b beam. I like to have only three of them. What's going to be? My problem going to be the same, but the slope deflection equation will be different. By this way, I like to have the slope at the beam over here. So the equation over here going to be 2EI over L. And for sure, this one is 2EI over L. But this one still 3EI over L. See, I control the problem to have only three unknown. The last one that may be possible, just thinking about theta sub c, delta, and theta sub b column. Ajahn, just change this one. And again, the problem still the same, but the set of the equation now change. You're looking for what? You're looking for the slope over here, right? When you're looking for the slope over here, this one going to be 2EI over L. You don't care about the slope over here. The slope at B for that beam, you don't care about it. So this one going to be 3EI over L. And then this one anyway is going to be 2EI over L, no matter you're going to change anything. This column keep the same because this column kind of general column. But the author, you can move as you prefer. Okay, so I left three of these for your practice. I will solve only for these two. Okay, only for these two. And let me move now. Sin Ajahn, provide you this. The equation you are going to use will be in the form of what I'm writing the pictures over here. This is going to be 3EI over L, 3EI over L. And last one over here is going to be 2EI over L, okay? Okay, right? Follow me, right? The problem going to be on this one to fill the result to this one. And the rest of this for your practice. And then what happened next? We start by the first one. We select this one. We got the set of equation like this. Now, for the second one, you're going to determine the fixed end moment. Now, this column DC going to have the fixed end moment, but this column and this beam has no fixed end moment. Since there is no external loading, act on the column AB and the beam DC. Okay, by doing this, we got to the column over here. This is C, this is D dot, and then you fix it over here, and then it's subjected to uniform load like this. By doing this, you got to rotate it a little bit, okay, to make thing like this. So by doing this, your beam going to be in this direction, and then it's going to rotate like this, right? From the table that we have. Virgo, you can follow me, right? From this one, is this a beam, is a column. But since we have the table in the form like this, we just rotate it like this. And then we compare it with what we have over here. The shape of this is going to be like this. If you understand the shape like this, this one will have in this direction. This one will be in this direction. And then you have this one to be fixed end moment CD. And it's going to be WL square over 12. And it's going to be 10 times this one is 4 meters times 4 square. And then divided by 12. That is going to be 160 divided by 12. It's going to be 13.333 kilonewton meter. Okay. Rotate it back. Okay. And then this one is going to be positive, right? No, it's going to be negative. This one is going to be positive. This one is going to be fixed and moment DC. Okay, that's for very first step. We supposed to have second. We will write the slope deflection equation. By writing the slope deflection, let me just actually I should not write this, but it's better to work close to each other. So if you like on this, actually I have a paper like this, but I don't think it's going to be better to like it over here. You see nothing. So to make the relationship, let me work on this. Okay, on examination, please use another paper to work on. And then I like you guys to start by writing a frame and trying to understand what you are looking for. And this is going to be A, B, C, and D. And the moment over here, rotate clockwise, always clockwise rotation. And this one going to be M sub A, B, right? And over here, M sub B, A is zero. It's no hinge, it's no hinge. And then you may write again, this one M sub B, oops, must be black, like it did. Okay, M sub B, C, this one M sub B, C, this one is zero, right? It's no hinge. And this one is M sub C, B. We are going to write it later. And this one is going to be M sub C, D. And this one is M sub D, C. Now we start with M sub A, B. And then going back to what we have from the previous discussion, this one, TEI over L. TEI divided by L is 4. And then for this one, it's going to be theta A minus delta over L, right? And then what we have from this one, going back to what we have over here. This term is going to come from this one. The rotation is in this direction. So we have this one for phi AB equal to delta over 4. Is this positive? No, it's going to be negative. So by doing this, just plug this one negative with the negative delta over 4. Okay. And then there is no fixed end moment on this one plus 0. This equation going to be 3EI. What this one is what? Theta sub A is 0, right? So we have this one plus minus and minus is going to be plus TEI delta divided by 16. This is the first equation. And this one has no, this one no. We go to another one, M sub CB. And this one related to this equation is going to be 3EI divided by the length. This length is 3, okay? And then we have the slope over here, theta sub C, okay? And the beam just has the same level from the, let's say, surveying the height after deformation, they are the same because there is no shortening of the column. Okay, so minus zero, delta is equal to zero, no relative settlement or delta, and then plus there is no fixed and zero. So this one just cut, you get this equation EI, let's say theta sub C, EI theta sub C. And then it looks straight, no? Just follow what it is in mathematics, okay? Then coming to this one, M sub CD. This set of equation will be used to EI over leg to theta sub C plus theta sub D minus this one. Okay, and what's going to be for this one, the linear line link between the point is like this. The rotation over here is this one. This one is phi sub C D equal to delta over 4. Is this one positive? No, it's going to be negative counterclockwise. This is going to be minus delta over 4. Okay. And then we have this one as a fixed end moment. Is this positive, Virgo? No, it's going to be negative. So minus 13.333. Okay. And then just reduce this, just making this simplify this one. This one will be 4EI theta sub C divided by 4. So it's going to be EI theta C. And EI plus EI theta D divided by 2, right? Divided by, oh no, theta sub D is over here. Theta sub D over here. That is no, this one. Okay, that thing is zero. And then this one positive is going to be 2EI delta. This one, 2EI delta over 16. So plus dy kit. This is going to be 2, right? Oh, sorry. 3. 3. Sorry on this. This one must be 3, right? M sub A B equal to EI over L 2 theta A plus theta B minus 3 delta over L. So we supposed to have 3 over here. And then that is going to be cut this to 3 EI delta over 8. And then minus 13.333. Okay. Okay. And then this one, M sub DC is going to 2 EI over 4. And then 2 theta D plus theta C minus 3, this one. And fixed end moment over here is going to be positive 13.333. Okay, and inside over here now, this is going to be phi D C for delta over 4 rotate in this direction, negative. Okay, it's going to be negative, and then delta over 4. You reduce this equation. Now this has zero value. This is going to be EI theta sub C divided by 2, and this one plus 3 EI delta divided by 8 plus 13.333. Now you finish by what? By finding the end moment equation or the slope deflection equation. You have three unknown. You're going to solve these three unknown. So go to the third step. On the third step, we're going to use the equation of equilibrium to determine theta sub c and delta, right? One is going to be related to the moment equation. One is going to be related to the equilibrium of force. Okay, let's see from the first one, the point C over here. The point C over here, one is subjected to M sub C B by the third law of Newton. This is going to be M sub C B. How about this one? M sub C D. By the third law, we have this one to be M sub C D. Okay. And by the summation of the moment at point C equal to zero, and put this one in the positive direction, we have M sub C B plus M sub C D, and then this one equal to zero. And let me say again, this one related to the slope at point C. Now we move to what we have M sub C B. This is M sub C B, is this one. And M sub C D is this one, and this term, and this term, and this term. See, we're going to combine all of them together. Now what we have is this one, and this one is going to be 2 EI theta C, right? Okay, this is 2 EI theta C, this one and this one, and plus 3 EI delta divided by this one, 8, and minus 13.333 equal to 13.333. And we put this one as the equation number one. Okay. This highlighter help you when you trying to combine them together. Now we move to this portion. By the summation of x sub x equal to zero, now we come to another picture. Let me put it over here, not over there. It's going to mess up a lot of things. Let me put this one. Okay, and then we also has this 10 kilonewton, and this one is 10 kilonewton per meter. By doing this, you're going to have the shear force occur over here. This is going to be V sub A, and this is going to be V sub D, right? And then put it in this direction, positive. So V sub A plus V sub D, and then it's going to equal to 10, and plus 10 times 4, And this equation going to be V sub A plus V sub D equal to 50 kilonewton. We can use it directly. We going to use the column now. This column, let's put this column. This going to be A, B. And at this point, we have the moment over here to be M sub A, B. And then we have this one to be V sub A. Okay, and for sure, we supposed to have this one, we supposed to have axial load, but they are not important. And now you may start by summation of the moment at B equal to zero. Take moment over here. Your V sub A must time the height. So for V sub A time four, rotate in this direction, and M sub AB, and then is equal to M sub AB. Your V sub A is going to be M sub AB divided by four. Okay, so what we have is this one is going to be M sub AB divided by four. And let's put it, V sub A will be equal to M sub AB is here, right? Oh yeah, yeah, it's going to be there. M sub AB divided by four. This is going to be the equation for shear. We will use it later. Now, we have another column that is over here. And then this one subjected to 10 kilonewton per meter. And at the end of this one, there is M sub CD, this one, M sub CD. And we have the shear V sub D over here. This one V sub D. On the top, we have M sub CD. M sub, this one is DC. This one, M sub CD. Now, we do the summation of the moment at this point C equal to zero. V sub D times 4 meters again, V sub D. V sub D time four. We got the moment rotate in this direction. And the red moment we have in the opposite direction. So it's going to be equal to M sub CD plus M sub DC. And we also has this one to be 40 kilonewton. So we plus 40 times two is gonna be 80, okay? And then our V sub D equal to M sub CD divided by four plus M sub DC divided by four plus this one to be 20. We got another equation. Now, we got to move. Let me put it over here, okay? And I will draw the moment diagram later. Let's plug this one. So then we have this one, M sub AB, this one, M sub AB divided by four. Now, for this one, plus M sub CD divided by four plus M sub DC divided by four plus 20. And then this one equal to 50. Okay. And what we have is M sub AB plus M sub CD plus M sub DC. We move this one, it's gonna be 50 minus 20 and then time 4. This one will be 120. Now, you guys must combine them together. Let me do it every step, okay? In order you be able to follow it. M sub AB, okay? M sub AB is over here. If you prefer, M sub AB now, this one. 3 EI delta over 16, 3 EI delta over 16. Now, you come to M sub CD, and then plus EI theta sub C, plus 3 EI delta divided by 8, minus 13.333. This is the second. The third, we come to this equation plus EI theta sub C divided by 2. If you like, you just put this one. And this one, 3 EI delta divided by 8 plus 3 EI delta divided by 8. And then the last one, plus 13.333, and then it's going to be equal to 120, and this one cut this one, okay? And following this, you got to have this one theta sub C, this one theta sub C is going to be 1.5 EI theta sub C. And then this 3 EI delta divided by 16, this 6 EI delta divided by 16, this is 6 EI delta divided by 16, 6, 3 plus 15 EI delta divided by 16, and then it's going to be equal to 120. Now you get this one as the second equation. You get this one as the first equation. You can solve it. Okay. Let me. This morning I quiz my student, but this time I won't quiz because if I quiz, I will go nowhere. We have only 15 minutes left. Let me put it like this. For we solve for EI theta C and EI delta. You just plug into your calculator. Very simple. Okay. You will get EI theta sub C. EI theta sub C equal to minus 24.762, and you get EI delta to be 167.619. What we have is our psi convention of this is correct. Okay. However, for this one, 24.762, since this one is negative, so when you write this one, that one is going to be counterclockwise. And we come to this one. See, this one is counterclockwise. And we have theta sub C equal to 24.762 6.62 divided by EI. Okay, and this one is going to be 167.619 divided by EI. And based upon this one, we must move over here, 167.619 divided by EI. Okay, and this one is 24.762 and then divided by EI. When you answer over here, please specify the direction also. Okay, this one also specify the direction. And let me put EI equal to 10 kilonewton per square meter, as we discussed from the previous example. So this one will be 24.762 and then divided by 10,000. This one will be 24.7610-4 radian. Okay, or you may put this one to be 2.4762 radian with the counterclockwise direction. Okay, and for this one you will get 167.619 divided by 10,000, or you may have this one for 16.7619 10-3 meter, or you may get this one to be 16.762 millimeter in this direction. And that is a proof that the deformation is very small, okay? Only 16 millimeter compared to the dimension of 3000 millimeter and 4000 millimeter. Okay, now let me move back over here. And then next, we find the end moment. We find the end moment. What we have is step by step, M sub A, B. This one is going to be 3/16. And then EI delta, that is 167.619. What you get, this one going to be 31.429 kilonewton meter and clockwise direction, positive. Okay, and then M sub CB. Okay, you do M sub CB equal to EI theta sub C. So you may take this one minus 24.762 kilonewton meter, or you may set 24.762 kilonewton meter. Change this one is going to be in the counterclockwise direction. Now this one M sub CD, M sub CD, this is CB, CB is going to be EI theta C minus 24.762 and then plus 3/8, and this one 167.619 and then minus 13.333. okay, you may put them together. You're supposed to get it to be plus this one, plus 24.762 kilonewton meter, and then this one and this one, they are equal. Okay, that means this one is correct. And the last one, M sub DC, you do it by yourself. That is going to be 63.809 kilonewton meter. And what we get from here, what we get from here, I'm going to move it a little bit to this page, okay? Now, what we have is the end moment. Let me put this one, 3 meter for B and C. And for the column, it's going to be 4 meter. Let me move it a little bit like this, okay? And this one is 4 meter. Let me zoom out. Ah, okay. This one a little bit better. This one is going to be A, B. And the last one for the column is going to be D, C. And what we get, M sub A, B. M sub A, B. M sub A, B is over here, clockwise. That is going to be 31.429 kilonewton meter. And M sub CB is over here. That is going to be counterclockwise for 24.762. Okay. And this one, we get 24 again, 0.762 kilonewton meter. Let's see, let's put this one kilonewton meter. And the last one over here, 63.809. Okay, this one is clockwise, 63.809 kilonewton meter. That means what we have changing, you take this one out. Okay, now you start by determining your shear force by doing this one. Okay, for sure. What we have. Oh, sorry, one thing I forgot. We have the equation for V sub AC. Okay, so we have V sub A equal to this one, 31.429. divided by 4. We get this one for 7.857 kilonewton. And we also have V sub D over here. Okay. V sub D is going to be M sub CD. M sub CD plus M sub DC. CD and DC. 24.762 plus 63.809 and divided by 4 and then plus 20. I will get this one to be 42.143 kilonewton. And then what I have going to be here, okay, it's going to be that shear. V sub A, V sub A. Don't forget V sub A and V sub D has this direction. We'll just put it back. This one for V sub A, 7.857 kilonewton. And this one, 42.143 kilonewton. Okay. And now for this one, for sure, you will get summation of F sub X equal to 0, 7.857 kilonewton. Okay. And for this one, we have this one for. Okay. So we have the load over here for 10 kilonewton per meter. And the force over here is 425123. So the shear over here is going to be this one minus 40 is going to be 2.143 kilonewton. Okay. And then over here, this is V sub B. We may take the moment over here, summation of the moment at B equal to zero. V sub C, this is 3 meter, is going to be 24.762. And V sub C, just divide it. It's going to be 8.254 kilonewton. So this is 8.254 kilonewton. And this is 8.254 kilonewton. Now, this one will transfer to this point. And if you recall, this is the internal hinge point B, 8.254 up over here. And then it's going to resist by this one and this one, 8.254 kilonewton. And for sure, this one will be 8.254 kilonewton. Now, 8.254 over here must act on this point C, and then it's going to be upward, and then this one is going to be downward, and this one going to be upward, 8.254 kilonewton, and this one 8.254 kilonewton. Now, not finished yet. 8.7, this one going to provide this one and balance by this one. And this point will subjected to 7.857 kilonewton. Or you may switch the direction between them, that's all. And then when you consider this one will be 7.857 kilonewton, and this one will act over here, and then we still have this one for 10 kilonewton. When 10 minus 7.567, you got this. That's correct. Now, for the shear diagram, you may come to this one and put this one to be the shear in kilonewton. And this one, X meter, you start here from zero. This is 4. 7.857, just put this one about 8 millimeter minus 7.857 and no W, so dV by dx equal to zero. Come over here and this one just crosses. And then come to the moment. This one is going to be X meter and this one is going to be moment in kilonewton meter. And then take this one out, zoom it a little bit. This moment, 31.429, when you put it in this side convention, this is positive. Okay. And then you may put it into about this one. And plus 31.429. And then dm by dx is going to be minus 7.857. And for sure, moment here is zero. This is going to be
a line like this.
And for this one, if you like to dock it, the normal force n kilonewton, this is in compression. Okay, this is in compression. You may say this is going to be minus 8.254 kilonewton normal force diagram. This one shear diagram. This one moment diagram. Nearly end of this lecture. This one going to be very easy. Okay, just move to this one. This one, the shear that we have over here. This shear force is downward 42.142 V kilonewton. Let me put this one to be 42. About this, minus 42.143. And then we have dV by dx equal to minus 10. Guys, this one is 2.143, okay? And it put in the upward direction. So for sure, this one will up like this. This one will be minus 2.143. And then the graph over here must be this one. Or you may think this is 42.140. This one, oops, sorry, positive. This is a tricky one because when we have load in this direction, dV by dx equal to minus 10. But this one in the opposite direction, so it's going to change to plus 10. Okay, and then the last one, the moment 63 is going to be positive. So let us put this one to be moment kilonewton meter. And this one is plus 63.809. And then slope over here, dm by dx equal to minus 42.413. Okay, this one, negative. And the moment over here, 24.476 in this direction is going to be minus 24.762. And the curve is going to be something close to this one. And this is zero. This is going to be dm by dx equal to this one, equal to minus 2.143. Okay, and this one is close. Huh, not beautiful. It's not on scale, so it's not beautiful. Okay, anyway, if you put this one will be upward shear of 8.254 and constant and close. The moment over here is zero. The moment over here is 24. So this one gonna be plus 24.762 and dm by dx equal to plus 8.254. dV by dx equal to zero. Okay, that's all for today. And then after you draw the diagram, you got to have this picture as the shear diagram and moment diagram. combine all of them together. And also, if you draw the elastic curve will be something like this. Okay, thank you very much. I took you 5 minutes past 3 o'clock. Bye-bye.